Yo guys, what's going on? Sceledrus here. Kept you waiting, huh? Anyways, it's no secret that my favorite anime franchise of all time is Neon Genesis Evangelion. I mean, just look behind me. I have a whole freaking shrine dedicated to the series. Although it's not nearly as popular here in the States, Evangelion has rightfully garnered its fans overseas. Its rise spawned tons of merchandise, everything from waist warmers to dehumidifiers, even canned bread. Taking the whole greatest things in sliced bread thing to a whole nother level. With the popularity of the original anime and the rebuild films, it was only a matter of time before Ava reached its goo-coated hands into the realm of video games. The first game to hit store shelves was simply titled Neon Genesis Evangelion for the Sega Saturn. It followed the anime very closely, with a few liberties taken here and there. Early Evangelion games followed a similar formula, retelling the anime, but with a few plot points altered here and there for fun. After a while, I guess they realized they could just tell whatever stories they want in game format and it wouldn't matter, and so they went balls to the wall. I'm talking strip mahjong with actual pornographic illustrations, typing games, dating sims, even rhythm games. When was the last time your favorite anime got official porn made of it? Yeah, I didn't think so. Checkmate, atheist. Speaking of evolution, remember Tamagotchis? If you're a zoomer like me, you probably don't, but they're like these little digital pets that like never shut up unless they die and need constant attention. Kinda like my ex. I'm sure whoever was in charge of Gainax back then saw the immense popularity of these things. And in 1999, Japan was graced with Neon Genesis Evangelion Shito Ikuse, or Angel Raising Project, developed by Bandai for the Wonder Swan. Now, what is a Wonder Swan, you may ask? I have no idea. I had to Google it myself. Apparently, it's this Japan-only Game Boy Color competitor. Anyways, in Angel Raising Project, you play as Ryoji Kaji, hired by Nerve to raise a cute little Adam embryo. The goal being to raise Adam to full maturity, in which it'll evolve within a week into one of 23 different forms depending on its environment. You control the embryo's LCL, energy, and AT field statuses. Depending on the levels of each status, they contribute to what form Adam takes at maturity. It can evolve into all of the angels from the show, including a few unique characters, like the three AO units themselves, Rei Ayanami, and even Penpen. Eventually, when the Adam embryo is at maturity, you can make it fight against the Evangelion units in a card game-styled minigame. It actually had a multiplayer mode where you could battle against your friends, but of course nowadays it's impossible without owning two Wonder Swans. To help further deepen the gameplay, you can explore Nerve HQ at any time to collect items to give to Adam, like medicine, or even talk with the other characters from the show. It's a neat little experience with nice sprites and fun gameplay. It's actually really surprising to see a game like this back then, especially when the main character of the show is based off of Takes a Back Seat. Earlier this year, the game was fully translated into English by a group of talented modders, so consider checking it out. It's a treat for diehard Evangelion fans. Now on a darker note, ever wonder how a Sherlock Holmes whodunit mystery would play out inside the Evangelion universe? Well, this game does all of that. And then some. Enter Detective Evangelion, a 2007 PS2 game developed by Broccoli Limited. Detective Evangelion is an original comedic murder mystery. You play as Shinji as you find clues to solve a series of murders and hold trials akin to the Phoenix Wright franchise. The game opens with Shinji Ikari being woken up by visions of his father, Gendo Ikari, being murdered. It then plays out similar to the first episode of the anime, but instead of the first angel Seichiel attacking Tokyo 3, it's an angel-possessed schoolgirl killing police officers, almost immediately setting the tone and breaking convention. Kaoru Nagisa in this universe is a detective working for Zila. Instead of Zila being a shadow organization, this time it's a courtroom. Suspects are called, with Kaoru being the judge while Shinji and Misato are the defense. It starts off with basic murder mysteries, but gets super graphic. Detective Evangelion also has various minigame sequences ranging in gameplay where you pilot an AVA unit to fight angels. A lot of the murder cases just completely break canon in ways I can't even begin to explain. Human-sized AVA units, mass-produced units showing up out of nowhere, Misato's father surviving the second impact somehow, and transforming into an Adam AVA unit hybrid. It gets really crazy, but still fun enough just for the sheer absurdity and little nods. There's a scene where Unit 1 moves on its own and grabs Shinji exactly like how Gendo witnesses instrumentality in End of Eva. It's little stuff like this that really makes me enjoy these spin-off stories no matter how batshit insane they get. Or another scene where Ritsuko shoots herself in the head like how Gendo did to her in End of Eva. But not only that, she falls and lands exactly where her mother did in the original series. It's like a double reference. This is the shit I live for. Detective Evangelion may be a crazy PS2 game to promote the new film, but its concept and execution would thrill any Evangelion fan. Too bad it didn't get localized or even a fan translation, as I'm sure more people would enjoy and talk about it if it were more accessible. Okay, how about something a lot less dark? In 2007, a comedy manga parody of the series called Petite Eva, Evangelion at School was released. It features all the characters in a super deformed chibi style as they attend junior high. In the same year, it was adapted into an original web series by the same name, eventually receiving a Nintendo DS game in 2008 published by Bandai. Petite Eva, Evangelion at Game is a minigame collection where you play as Shinji Ikari going through each week represented by a minigame. There are 5 different types of minigames: Touch Adventure, Touch Action, Touch Puzzle, Tapping Time, and Heart Quiz. Can you guess what you mainly do in this game? If you couldn't tell by the name alone, you touch the touchscreen. Evangelion at Game takes full advantage of the DS's touchscreen mechanics almost a little too well. Touch Adventure levels utilize a point-and-click mechanic, asking the players to use the DS touchpad to draw circles around different items to progress through the level's dialogue tree. Touch Action levels are side-scrolling action segments in which the player must move various objects in and out of Shinji's role to get to a goal before a timer runs out. Touch Puzzle levels involve moving objects around on the screen to complete a variety of challenges such as rearranging wire puzzles and solving math problems, keeping with the school theme. Tapping Time levels require the player to rapidly tap the touchscreen with a stylus in order to keep up momentum and reach a goal within time. And finally, Heart Quiz levels operate like a game show where the other players provide questions and statements to Shinji, and the player's job is to select the best response from a list of answers. Not much can be really said for this game, other than it's a game. It exists. It's a thing. It's kind of like a mix between Rhythm Heaven and Cooking Mama if I were to describe the gameplay. The gameplay is quite repetitive, but the dialogue is just good enough to keep you entertained. For some reason, Unit 01 lives with Shinji and is named Evancho and is a delinquent, gentle giant type. I don't know, it's really kind of weird. It's throwing me off. Hashtag not my Unit 01. Despite that, I do like the designs of the various angels. Like, you see this lanky boy? Just as big and long as they want to be. This is him now in Petite Eva. They waifu-wise my boy. Also, these baby mass-produced Eva are so fucking cute. I want and need a plush of them ASAP. Looking like a stumpy little Kezu. And look at Zuru, he's got this officer hall monitor kind of look. It's kind of snazzy. In the story, they give Evancho a mech suit with a similar design and color petite as the Type F Unit 01 from the PS2 game Neon Genesis Evangelions, which is pretty cool considering it's my favorite non-canon unit design. Evangelion at Game is actually the very first instance of Mari Makanami Illustrious officially being shown, albeit not her final design like in 2.0 because by then the movie hadn't been released. The entire playthrough is on YouTube with an unofficial English patch if you're interested in playing it for yourself. And with that, we've come to an end. These were the most forgotten Evangelion games, in my opinion. Now yes, most of these games have full Let's Plays and English patches, so they technically don't count as forgotten, don't get me wrong, but I very rarely hear anyone talk about them, and they're too unique to not have a spotlight on them. I was originally going to include Misato Katsuragi's reporting plan on this list as it's truly forgotten, seeing as it was an online-only PS3 game that's obviously defunct, and there's little footage of it out there. Strangely enough, the website for it is still up apparently. You can download some sort of like time-sensitive video file off of there, but it's no longer accessible. In the game, you can dress up Misato, hear the local news in her voice, and even make your own reports. Seems like a total waste of game development time due to how incredibly niche and bizarre it is, and it was shut down a year later. I hope in the near future we receive more Evangelion games. Who knows, maybe the last rebuild films will be enough to warrant another one. There's actually rumors of a CyberConnect 2 Evangelion game in the works. It's probably super fake, but still, one can dream. While I go off and dream, consider liking, sharing, and subscribing if you enjoyed the video. And with that, I'll catch y'all later. Peace.